Hi, I'm Andrea, and this is another one of my videos. I never thought that I would try Windows 8 because I'd read about it on different sites on the web, and I'd seen different videos about Windows 8, and I wrongly thought that Windows 8 was, you know, difficult to use and that it didn't have a start menu, and that was one of the main things that put me off the Metro theme. But I decided to try Windows 8 Developers Preview, and I installed it on one of my netbooks. It used to have was one of my netbooks that used to have Windows 7 on it, but I upgraded it to Windows 8, and I'm running Windows 8 Developers Preview as the only operating system on the netbook. See if I can show you. It's this netbook here. It's just a 1 gig netbook, a notebook, or whatever you want to call it. The only operating system it has on here is Windows 8. You can disable the Metro theme with a simple registry edit, and once you do that, Windows 8 is like Windows 7, and even when Windows 8 is in the Metro theme, it's very similar to Windows 7. Apart from the Metro theme, you would think that if you were running Windows 8 that it was Windows 7. You wouldn't really know the difference, apart from, of course, the Metro theme, which most Windows users like myself have chosen to disable. The good news about Windows 8 is, like all the other versions of Windows, you don't have to have a password on your administrator account. You don't have to log in with a password, and you can have a password, but like all the other versions of Windows, on Windows 8 you don't have to have a password if you don't want one. So I don't have a password, and you don't have to have a password to do anything on your computer, unlike Linux, where you're forced to have a password. But on Windows 8 you don't have to have a password if you don't want one, which is sheer heaven, because I hate using a password. And most of the programs for Windows XP and Windows 7 and even earlier versions of Windows, like Windows 2000, will work on Windows 8. There's one or two applications that won't work on Windows 8. Windows Mail for Windows Vista doesn't work on Windows 8 at all. Despite my best efforts, I couldn't get Windows Mail to run. But however, the Vista sidebar, or the Windows sidebar from Windows Vista, does run on Windows 8, and Windows Calendar runs on Windows 8, Windows Live Messenger for Windows XP runs on Windows 8, and all of the Windows Movie Makers, including Windows Movie Maker 2.1 for Windows XP, is running on Windows 8, as are all of the other versions of Windows Movie Maker. Windows Movie Maker 6, Windows Movie Maker 2.6, and 2.1 is all running on Windows 8. AIM Messenger doesn't run on Windows 8, but I think this is because AIM Messenger depends more on Internet Explorer than what it does on what the other messengers do. And unfortunately, on Windows 8, the lowest version of Internet Explorer you can run is Internet Explorer 10. You can't run Internet Explorer 8 on Windows 8 because it won't let you. Windows 8 was never brought out with Internet Explorer 8. You can't even run Internet Explorer 9, just Internet Explorer 10. I don't like Internet Explorer 9 or 10, but on Windows 8, unfortunately, there isn't any choice. You have to run Internet Explorer 10 because you can't run Internet Explorer 8. Anyway, I'm going to show you a demonstration of Windows 8, first briefly with the Metro theme, and then how I normally use it with the Metro theme disabled. Well, this is the netbook that I'm running Windows 8 on. It used to have Windows 7 on it. It's an HP Mini 210 1 gig RAM netbook, just a notebook or netbook, or, you know, doesn't have a CD drive or anything, but you can use a plug-in CD drive if you need to burn CDs on a netbook. And this used to have Windows 7 on it, but I've installed Windows 8 Developers Preview on this netbook, and I'm running Windows 8 as my only operating system. I'm going to boot up now and show you. And it boots quite quickly, quicker than Windows 7. Windows 8 is slower than Windows 7. It's not as fast as Windows 7 or Windows XP. And I think it uses more energy. There's the start screen of Windows 8. You can see it's different from Windows 7. There you are. And this is how it is in Metro theme, first of all. And I'm not going to keep it in Metro. I'm just showing you for demonstration purposes. And this is Windows Explorer. I've customized that icon to make Windows 98 icon. These are the apps here that you have, but none of these apps work because I think you need a screen resolution that's high, and the netbook will only go to a certain high screen resolution, so these apps don't work. But these apps here are all of the software that I have installed myself, and this is all the software I've installed myself. I've installed Classic Shell, which puts the classic start menu back into Windows 7, Windows Vista, and of course Windows 8. And these are all the these tiles here are the apps that I have installed myself. All of the software that I installed myself. And I'm going to click on one of my apps. I mean, I can launch my software from here. This is Advanced Browser, which was made for Windows XP, but runs on Windows 8 and runs on Windows 7. And you know, and the default browser for this is Internet Explorer 10. But look what happens when I type in it works, and I'm going to one of the browser sniffer sites that's supposed to tell you what browser you're using. Whatbrowser.org, that's a good site. And this is really interesting because it's the Internet Explorer-based web browsers like Advanced Browser, Pink Browser, and Ace Explorer run off Internet Explorer. But look, it says I'm using Internet Explorer 8. So when I use Advanced Browser and my other Internet Explorer-based browsers or Internet Explorer shells, Internet Explorer 8. But it says I'm running Internet Explorer 8, so I think that the reason why a lot of the software runs is it's still got, Windows 8's got some of the coding of Internet Explorer 8 in it. Although when I run this is Internet Explorer 10. You see I have the normal desktop now. It's still in Metro, but you go to the normal desktop because that's where I launched my program from. This is going to be Internet Explorer 10 that's going to be coming up in a minute. Internet Explorer 10. Yes. Internet Explorer 10. There you go, Internet Explorer 10. This is what it looks like. I don't like Internet Explorer 9 or 10 on Windows 7. You can install Internet Explorer 9, but it's very, very, very slow. So on Windows 7, I use Internet Explorer 8. I've never, ever upgraded, and most of the apps on Windows 7 and Windows Vista work better with Internet Explorer 8 or 7. Well, on Windows 7, you've got Internet Explorer 8, so you have to use 8. But I've never used Internet Explorer 9. They say this is a Metro version of Internet Explorer, but I don't know. And let's go to the What Browser website and see what it says here. This is interesting. Because should say I'm running Internet Explorer 10. So when I'm in Internet Explorer 10, the browser sniffer websites say Internet Explorer 10, but when I'm in Advanced Browser, it says Internet Explorer 8. So it must be using some of the coding from Internet Explorer 8 in Internet Explorer. I'm not sure about this. Sorry we couldn't... Oh, interesting. You are using... Sorry we couldn't recognise your browser. That's because Internet Explorer 10 is not officially out. This is just a developer's preview of 10. And this is the desktop, but this is how you get to the Metro start screen. And whoosh. We're back at the start screen. And control panel works. Try that again. Oh, this is Classic Shell. Yes, I've installed Classic Shell, and this gives me a Windows XP start menu that I can use with the Metro theme or without the Metro theme on Windows 8. But I'm going to turn the classic start menu off because it defeats the object of the Metro theme. So this is control panel. Ah, here we are. This is what I was looking for, the settings, and got the settings here in control panel. And in part 2 of the video, I will show you more of Windows 8. There's quite a lot to see with Windows 8 because it's a new operating system, and I'm going to show you Windows 8 with the Metro theme and also with the Metro theme disabled. So stick around for part 2 and I'll see you in part 2. Bye!